Welcome to the third video in the Copilot for Security Flight School series. I'm Ryan Munch, your flight instructor. If you're watching this video, we're going to assume you've watched the prior two lessons and you have an instance of Copilot for Security ready to go. If you don't have Copilot ready to go, head over to MS Learn to begin your flight checks. Starting with this episode, we are going to spend most of our time in the platform walking through how to become an ace at Copilot for Security. In this video, we'll talk about how we think of workflow and enabling operators to be successful no matter their background. Security systems, data, and processes should be democratized and made available to anyone or any process that needs it. No longer should it be something reserved only to the most specialized, trained, and tenured individuals. That's what makes security hard, and it's why there is such a shortage of security professionals. An operator, defined as a person engaged in the operation of a job, function, or workflow in a business, is someone assessing or augmenting a security context. They could come from any discipline, such as cybersecurity, IT, data management, or more. The operator has a workflow that incorporates security, and it could start or be augmented from anywhere. Copilot allows the operator to interact with security workflows from either one of two experiences: the standalone portal or a Copilot skill embedded within a system. In this flight training, we'll cover both types. This is the homepage for the standalone Copilot experience. It allows you to quickly start a new workflow or navigate to prior ones. That's what you see here on the top of my screen: my prior sessions. These reflect past workflows that I've augmented with the help of Copilot. Copilot is a stateful AI platform, which means my sessions are retained and indexed. Anytime a prompt is invoked, whether in the standalone or embedded experiences, a session is created and indexed for reference. The session menu retrieves my entire history and provides options to filter, search for, manipulate, or extend prior sessions. Searching against the history for user lockout events gives me some options for manipulations. I could, for example, open a prior session to pick up a workflow. What the results here have identified is that I have a lot of common user account state sessions, which I could later streamline with prompt books. For now, I'll duplicate this session, then rename it to User Account Lock Prompt Book Candidate. I also have the option to delete any unwanted session from my history, which I can do by selecting the boxes next to my session and clicking Delete. Now let's examine plugins and how we can enable and extend capabilities for Copilot for Security. In the prompt bar are the sources. One source, plugins, control what workflows you can initiate in the standalone or embedded experiences. The ability to control and add plugins is unique to the standalone experience. This is why you will come here to sometimes extend workflow from embedded solutions, or in some cases may even start a workflow here. Let's quickly highlight some of the plugin categories. Microsoft will provide several Microsoft-developed and automatically provisioned plugins. They work with on-behalf-of-user authentication, meaning if you don't have access to a system outside of Copilot, you won't gain access through the use of Copilot. Microsoft provides plugins for the security suite, IT systems, and Azure. Microsoft has created an ecosystem for the platform that provides plugins that can connect to any partner. In some cases, Microsoft may develop them, but in most cases, the partner will develop plugins such as Red Canary, Tanium, URLscan, and Graynoise. There are also over 60 partner-developed plugins on the way. You can further extend the Copilot platform through custom plugins to any dataset or system in your environment, either by leveraging what is in the OpenAI marketplace, building your own, or perhaps leveraging one from a trusted partner. We'll cover the custom plugin options in depth in a later video. By providing extensibility, you can begin addressing fragmentation that exists within security environments, make security accessible in any context, and redefine what security is and how security gets done. Plugins control what work can be achieved with Copilot, so let's focus on some of the different ways to begin a workflow in the standalone experience. Across the middle are featured prompts, which reflect different skills assembled from available plugins. Plugins, as we covered in the second episode of Flight School, are extensions of the Copilot platform. If you're not sure how to start or suffer from a bit of artist dilemma, featured prompts will get you airborne. A different option to start with are prompt books, which represent a common workflow we want to replicate more readily. With prompt books, you specify an input and through predefined prompts arrive at repeatable outcomes. They are great for accelerating common workflows and gaining exposure to advanced concepts. To recap, the standalone experience is your point of management for controlling sources in the Copilot platform. It is also great for augmenting workflows that canvas highly heterogeneous environments. As we'll learn next, it also extends workflows coming from any number of different embedded experiences. A workflow with a security context could begin or start anywhere. And sometimes as an operator, you may begin workflow in a specific system or even work exclusively from it. Regardless, Copilot should be able to help you, and we create an embedded experience for just that purpose. I'm going to spend the next few minutes with some of our embedded experiences designed for security and IT operators. A common starting point for security practitioners is within their XDR solution. For some, this can also be exclusively where they operate all their security operations. It's why there are so many different embedded experiences available to you, the operator. We've now landed in the Defender XDR portal, and we are looking at an incident involving human-operated ransomware. This, at a glance, is obviously complicated. Rationalizing all 71 alerts and discerning from them the relevant takeaways incurs time and effort. If I click the Copilot button at the top, it will take the alerts and compose a summarization of the incident while also supplying options for guided response. This provides insight and suggestions useful to advancing my workflow. From the summary, I learned more about the nature of the attack, the compromised account, the script executed to download a payload to exploit SMB configs and traverse my network. Complementary to the summary is the guided response. There are four categories: triage to help classify, containment, actions to contain, investigation, recommendations for extending investigations, and remediation, which are response actions. What is available is incident dependent, and in this one, it is containment and investigation. Let's follow the suggestion of Copilot summary and examine the script. After navigating to it, you'll note that this is obfuscated using an encoding technique, a common practice of threat actors used to confuse and make the analysis process more difficult for humans. Unintentionally, they also created a hurdle for AI. None of the 328,000 large language models in the world would have the token capacity to analyze this. It's a case where Defender XDR helps by first deobfuscating the script, so then Copilot can analyze it. Normally, script analysis is a really difficult thing. Not everyone can do this, but with Copilot, it is now a core competency of any operator. Given what I've now learned, my interest has been piqued about the script itself. I can use another embedded experience to analyze the script file hash, then extend the investigative workflow in Copilot standalone. Behind the scenes, each embedded action creates a session and invokes a skill within Copilot before displaying the results in Defender. This linking allows me to easily augment my workflow however I elect to do so. In this case, let's run a search for the file hash across my environment using Defender. Here, Copilot executes the natural language to KQL skill, a security-specific transformer, to conduct the hunt. After it's completed, you'll note a blue link that allows me to go back, or I could elect to remain here in the standalone experience. Since this is the portion of Flight School talking about embedded experiences, you already know where I'm going to go. However, note here what a phenomenal display of interoperability. Wherever you decide to head next in your workflow, Copilot is there with you. Within the advanced hunting embedded experience, I can run the query I did before, work with suggestions from Copilot, or use natural language to modify the existing or generate a net new hunting query. With the NL to KQL ability, what was previously some of the most specialized work in security is now approachable by all. I've just demonstrated how embedded and crossover experiences accelerate incident workflow. Are there other experiences that could help? Perhaps I decided to start my day by tackling risky devices. I can sort by the device risk, examine the most pressing ones, such as Park City Win 10S, and if I dive deeper, Copilot helps provide a summary and gives me an understanding of the most critical elements of risk. Being presented with the significance, I can now examine its associated incidents, such as the one we just examined. That's a wrap on the different Copilot experiences. We'll catch you at the next stage of flight school as we walk through additional embedded experiences across operators. Remember your aviators. I'm Ryan Munch, and I'll catch you next time, pilots.